step is 192, and the time is about 14:52, 53 on a piece of net we found. Good ground color, number of floats there. Zero in and pan. No. No. Well, it's kind of old. You got to see an enemy on
there?
Where? Right on top?
No, I see it.
A little bit to see it.
Look at it from the other side, maybe. Yeah.
They might like a good shot of it too.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, is that? No, that's a sea anemone on top.
Yeah, growing on that float right there.
Second net to be seen, depth is 203. We first saw it at about 15:13. Looks like a starfish.
Starfish wrapped around that guy? Is that what it is? No,
a starfish
there.
On the other side of the float. What he's feeding on, I'm not sure.
Huh. Either that or a sponge bro, huh?
Yeah. Well, there may be a sponge on there right at first, you know, and then...
Yeah.
I don't see any fish in it, though, do you?
No, not a one.
And there's a net in the picture now working up with one fish, which I can't identify. Quite badly decomposed within the net.
Depth is 220.
And the net runs up with three or four floats supporting it at the top.
Frank, we stopped. We've got a net up.
And the screen of view is about five piranha. The rest are Asterias. A crab up in the right-hand corner. Answer crab. And we'll make one more pan up through the net. And there we have the entangled fish, which I still... And we'll begin to transect and run up along this net. You can see it just to the left here as it runs up and through. The visibility is about 20 feet. Material is already grown on the net. Looks like a colonial Breyers Owens. None of it?
None of it.
Yeah.
Let's start over again.
Okay, we're at the end of the net. It only went for a section about 20 feet. There was a second dogfish whose body is hollowed out. It's been there a lot longer than the first one. The net in between is suspended up about 3 feet off the bottom, and at each end there is twisted masses, and this mass on this end runs up to about 10 or 12 foot height. At the bottom there is the same type of cancer crabs entangled. Some of these are alive and sea stars. that have been attracted. The net runs up vertically, supported by the floats. With no fish, there's a float in view now that has some large barnacles on it. Some growth of bryozoans and other encrusting invertebrates within the webbing of the net itself. And the net loops up to the top, suspended to begin by a few floats. Section is 20 feet long with about a 6 foot twisted mass on one end and probably a 10 or 12 foot twist, high twist on the other end.
Examples of dogfish mortality in the net, partially decomposed. Net seems to be rising on the float line off bottom and about scallop shapes, 3-4 foot height off bottom. That's good. There's sections that are broken through at 3 or 4 foot panel rips in the net. Much of this net is lodged underneath the fairly large cobble to small boulder. There's a...
Okay, we're traveling along the net, taking video. We're going east.
Okay, this illustrates the panel tear out portion of the net. Up ahead we have, looks like some more dogfish mortality. Okay. There's a group of three dogfish, look like recently caught dogfish within the last 3 days. Just signs of Asterius predation, no cancer crabs as yet. There's some carapaces of Cancer borealis along the net. Can't distinguish whether they're molt casts or... That's good. That's, yeah. That's showing they have swung from the east-west position slightly towards the north. That's good. Good. Yeah. Now it is arcing around to the right front of the sub. Seems to be exclusively dogfish that's been gilled and trapped by this gross portion of gill net. There's a close-up of the cod jig. Looks like a recent loss. Dead cancer crab right along the lead line of the net. We'll take the zoom back and illustrate this panel, which will show everything from a lobster to a cod jig. We'll try a pan to the right here. Lobster right at the base of the net. See Asterius on the rock behind the net to the left. Up and over this panel section's, what would you estimate, Don? About 3 feet, 4 feet
off
high?
The bottom, yeah. About 3 feet.
About 3 feet off the bottom. There's a Boltinia attached to the mesh of the net itself. Illustrating the net has probably been on bottom for a season, at least.
Keep going.
Yeah, yeah, this is good. Okay, so okay, there we are on the, well, it may be a wolffish. It looks like a small wolffish, about a foot and a half in length. It's been gilled. There's small signs of predation around the vent of the wolffish.
They had mine.
I'd like to see how long it runs while it's still fishing. There's quite a bit of mortality.
You want to take it out to the end?
Yeah, I'd like to see the length. We're approximately...
Well, Lance said we're going to take it out to the end.
Does that look like... Looks like long line gear?
No.
Looks like a piece of eighth-inch cable or nylon line that might have been long line gear that directly intersected the gillnet.
To Frank? Fine.
Looks like the cork spacing is approximately 5 to 6 feet on the head rope line. We've probably passed, let's say, 100 yards of this. What would you say?
Oh, a little more, maybe.
A little more? Maybe
100 yards.
150?
Yeah, I'd say so.
150 yards of this goat.
That's the fifth dogfish. We have another skate coming up. It's caught.
Geez, they're really raising hell down here, too, aren't they? Kicking up all that.
And they are really churning the net up and around. There's another fish here that is an old dogfish with the liver hanging out. It's well deteriorated. That's the sixth dogfish. The seventh, eighth, and ninth are in sight. We traverse maybe 50 foot of net. There's a codfish in the background beyond the net. There's a rock right up here, too.
Yes,
right.
Yeah.
The net turns.
Yeah.
Too. We're into a pocket in the net. There's the 10th, 11th dogfish. Very live dogfish stuck in the middle of the net. And we understand from the fishermen that the dogfish normally come into the nets during the day, so these are probably fish that have just very recently been caught. And you see how active this dogfish totally tangled in the net in such a way that he's upside down, stuck and swimming wildly. As we were coming into the net, it looked like the eel fowl was eating the dead shark carcass. We've noticed, this is about the fourth eel fowl we've noticed, ocean pout, beside the net. None of them seem to be stuck there, but they are right next to it. Eating the remains of the shark.
It's actually under the net, isn't it?
Okay, I've got this codfish. He's tangled in the net. He was swimming fiercely when we first came up, but now he's placid. He must be fairly freshly caught. There's not much of anything else in this net. The codfish is rolling the entire net right up. You can see how this is about, the net is about at the height of the working bar on the submarine, which must be 6 or 8 feet off the substrate. The codfish has pulled the whole float line down to within about 2 or 3 feet of him. So he's there's a flounder right beside us on the bottom heading towards the net. He's shying away from it, though he realizes that there's something there. There's a dogfish up in the
right
net.
Under.
Right under
it. Surge here.
Surge. Looks like we have something right there near the net. Probably a wolffish. Doesn't seem to be caught into it.
Turn it this way.
Well, I've got a wolffish right here. Mark, see him? Right in the air.
See, I don't have enough light on it.
There you can see a wolffish caught in the net, struggling a bit. We can maintain that a little bit, get a good shot of him. We get a shot of his reactions to the net. The net starts off just to the left of this picture for maybe about 12 feet, maybe a little more.
He's free.
He's free. Here's another case where fish triumphs over man. I think Beth will probably like this, seeing the wolffish, this poor creature of the sea, get free from his gill net. Apparently he wasn't tangled in too well.
Now, I wonder if we ought to follow that other line and see if the high flyer's on there.
Wonder what that is right there. What does that look like to you, those big, huge claws? What are those things?
Claw?
You see him?
Oh, that's a lobster.
That is a big lobster.
This crab has a big claw.
Yeah, I want to...
Lobster got caught in there.
Look at the size of that claw. Are we videoing this? Yes, we are.
Hope so.
Try and zoom in on that.
Be careful.
Look at the size of that claw. Think we can pick it up? I lost sight of it now. We're getting closer. See it? It's right there. Big.
Here, see if you can get it.
Okay.
Be careful you don't get caught in the net with it. I'll try to get down.
I can't see it. It's right all in the net. Do you still want me to do it?
Yeah, grab it and see if you can pull it away from the net.
Okay. I think I got it.
You got it?
Yep. Oops, nope, I just lost it. Okay.
We won't tell them we have it. See, what a surprise. It's not in the net, though. That's what
it is. Yeah, it's in the net still. Oops, you just dropped it. There, now I think you got it, but it's stuck all in the net. That is the hugest claw I've ever seen. There you go. Uh-oh.
Got it somehow.
Get it out of
the claw, out of the... It doesn't look like it's tangled very bad.
No, it doesn't. Just a couple strands. There, now you got it. Stuck in there, though. These fish are all hanging out.
Let's see if...
Want me to hold it?
Yeah, if you can hold it, let me get the...
Okay.
Got it tight?
Yep.
And we'll back away and see if we can pull it loose from the net.
Okay. All right. I think you still got it in there. Yep, you're doing good. Coming with us.
Yeah, shoot. I wonder if we pull it straight up or whatever.
I don't know.
Is it coming up with it?
Yep, the whole thing's coming up. What a shame. That'd be neat. Happening. Oops. Okay, I think you dropped it. It's just stuck on the arm a little bit.
There.
There you go.
Now where's the claw?
Oh, it's still tangled all up in there. Right below us.
There's a fishing lure in it too.
Yeah. I've never seen claws like that. That's amazing.
Let's see if it's not.
you see it?
We're sitting on a big boulder.
Oh, is that the problem?
Yeah.
We're kind of balancing, like, right near it.
Actually, we...
See it?
I think we tangled it more, don't you?
No, no, no. Hard to tell. You're pretty good with that thing.
Darn it, I wanted that. Well, I'm afraid we're not going to get it.
Doesn't look good,
we tangled
huh?
it more. It looked like a fish.
We are going to take a fix on you. Is there still video in? Is that correct?
Yep. We're videoing.
That's a roger.
Okay, just stay there.
See the lure on there, too?
Yeah, I see it. Big one. Look at the size of that thing.
Poor guy, he really got tangled up, didn't he?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm afraid we're not going to be able to get it. That's too bad.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll go on just a little bit.